good afternoon, everybody. And welcome to our fairy tale. Allereerst een paar woorden in het Nederlands. Namens het Amsterdam Gaming Scores wil ik jullie bedanken voor jullie aanwezigheid. We zijn trots en blij om hier na 3 jaar weer te mogen zijn met jullie en het Podium Mozaïek. Now you can see how I've been spending the lockdown. thank you so much for being with us this evening. We've really lifted our chorus up. This is the middle show of our run, and we are so happy that you've been joining us this afternoon. Really wonderful to see us, to be here with you this afternoon. You are most welcome to take photos and videos, and of course don't forget to tag us at AMSGMC on Instagram, or of course also on social media. Now, did you notice, like every good fairy tale at the theatre, the first act seemed to come to an end just as it seemed like everything was starting to get out of hand? Well, while our three fairy tale heroes are living their beautiful nightmare, I'm very pleased to say that our chorus is in very safe hands, and that's where I'd like to start this afternoon, by thanking 4 people in particular. First of all, our brilliant musical director, Joost van Velzen. Artistic director and choreographer, who's at the top there, Maarten van Grootel. And then, of course, our talented and very patient pianist who's with us in all of our rehearsals is Josh Mills. The man responsible for bringing all of this together, the production, and kind of bringing all the many pieces of this jigsaw together is Marco van Leeuwen, who is up here. We are also here this afternoon. We'd very like to say a special thank you to the people who have sponsored our program. You'll see inside we have Club Church. Some of you may know it well. Club Church, for all the mums, I can see there's a few mums and dads in the audience, but for Club Church isn't a Bible study group, just so that you know. We're also sponsored by Sound and Neuroside. Some of you may know that well as well. We decided to offer you the authentic sauna experience this afternoon as part of that sponsorship deal. Apologies to the people sitting down here in the front rows who might be getting sweat in their direction. Some people like that as well. No, really, for the first time in forever, it's wonderful to be back here with you all. But behind our fabulous fairy tales, our show does have a very serious message, because, unfortunately, around the world, many people have lived and continue to live their own bad time stories. And when you grow up LGBTQ, which is a label, of course, you get later on in life, usually, but when you grow up feeling different, when you grow up feeling maybe even chucked out of your home or bullied at school, is it any wonder that young people turn to that magical world of handsome princes, fairy tale castles, or fairy godmothers, or in our case, hairy godfathers? But it's of course something that we feel very passionate about as a chorus. So perhaps, you know, many people have also lived their own bad time story. Perhaps it was you standing alone on the platform, with everything you own in a little black case, alone in the platform, the wind and rain on a sad and lonely face. So where did you go? Well, for many people over the decades, that place has been Amsterdam, a city where you can turn up, find a job and be accepted for who you are. A city which over many years has grown a global reputation for being open-minded, where you will be accepted for who you are. A city of innovation, and of course a very international city. And those are the values which also we want to reflect in the Amsterdam Gay Men's Chorus. Our nearly 80 members come from nearly 30 countries, as far away as New Zealand and Chile, Argentina, Vietnam, China, Syria, and of course as close to home as Boston Longer. YOLO in Bolo, remember? Well, this is what we're doing this afternoon. So of course, while it might seem like all we do is singing and dancing, ultimately we are here for accepting each other and for supporting each other. And believe me, in the gay world, that is a precious thing. For many of our members, joining can be like moving out of the darkness and into the spotlight, a place where we belong. So, we are very happy. On behalf of the whole chorus, it makes us very happy to be able to share with you what this teamwork, friendship, and hard work can produce. So, where will the plot go next? As we all, of course, know, as we said, we would take you on an emotional roller coaster, and as we know, life can be full of surprises. So, I'm going to leave you in the company of our chorus to take you on the next stage of tonight's journey. Thank you.
Ran out of the palace into the woods, their head full of questions. Who am I? And what if people do not accept me for who I am? Suddenly, a fairy godfather appeared, called by the cries of this beautiful little person in the woods. Thank you. After the ball, at daybreak, the stimulants lose control of the car. He comes to senses and realizes everybody saw the big, healthy influencer fall from his ivory pedestal into the gutter. By now, his drunk and embarrassing behavior must be all over the internet. His career would surely be cursed. To hide his shame, he wanders through the woods towards the lake. The waves seem soothing. The cool water calls. Work. Suddenly, he sees someone in the water. He stretches out his hand and lifts an unconscious Carl into his boat. He brings him to the shore. A group of villagers walk by and recognize him. filled with sadness, they see this lost being.
Show it our face. In the woods, the fairy godfather still looked down on Alice. "Why are you crying?" asked the fairy godfather. "I don't know who I am. He, she, they. When people look at me, I feel so insecure. What do they think?" "Does it matter?" said the fairy godfather. "You do not need labels to define yourself. Oh, I truly wish you could see the world as I see it. Oh, wait, try these." And he handed Alex his glasses. "Thanks," Alex said, but the fairy godfather was already gone. And when they looked through them, they saw everyone around them as creatures that a man and woman can buy. But they are not scary. They are creatures of love, all different and unique, just like Alice. And happily, they eased on down the road home.
Pain and love.
Thank you.